Meera, firstly, welcome to the show. And you know, this is an extremely different field, an unconventional field, like Formula 4 racing. But tell us something about your journey and how, what inspired you basically to step your foot in this industry.
So back in 2009, my dad started a go-karting track in my hometown in Vadodara. And I was 8 years old. I was just there having fun with my brothers. And, you know, there was always this passion that I had in me that was, you know, speed. And I was always fascinated by cars. So after a year of driving with my brothers, my dad asked me if I wanted to get into professional racing and, you know, take it up as a serious sport. I mean, I was 9 back then in 2010 when he asked me. And I had no idea how, you know, the whole world of motorsport works, but I was just excited that I would be able to go ahead and drive and, you know, experience what real racing is. So I took it up. I went to see one of the national racing championships in Pune at that time. And that's when I saw that motorsport is a male dominated sport. And there are very, very few females, you know, who are participating. Especially when I went into racing, there was no other female in India who was racing with me. So that was something that motivated me more, that I want to continue this as a sport and, you know, spread the word of females can actually drive as well and also follow my own passion. So yeah, that's how my journey started. I got professionally trained for a week or so, and like in total 25 days of training and practice, and I was there at my first ever national racing championship after that in Hyderabad.
Awesome. So I think your parents were also pretty supportive about this.
They were the ones, exactly. They were the ones who encouraged me to follow my passion, that was racing. And they have always been with me since the day one. We always travel by car most of the time to every different part of the country. So it's my mom and dad that they always have been traveling for each and every race of mine, be it in India or international as well. And I think I'm lucky enough to have such parents who believe that, you know, females can actually race as well. And they never really, you know, cared about what people used to say, that she's a girl, she's, you know, why are you spending so much behind her, because she's gonna leave one day. My dad would always say that no matter what, even if she's a girl, if she's really passionate about something, I will give my best to make sure that she achieves her dreams. So in that sense, I was really lucky.
Awesome. So, you know, when you're on that racetrack and, you know, the race is just about to start, what are those feelings that a racer experiences?
That feeling is totally different. You know, it's very, it feels like home to me personally, because the day I started racing, the first time I was actually on the racetrack, and, you know, just before the race was about to start, I was really scared because I had never experienced something like that before. And but at the same time, I was even more excited because this was totally new for me. And racing faster cars at a professional level racetrack, it was a surreal feeling for me. And after that, it always feels like home to me. Every time I'm about to start the race, I forget everything else, because what I believe is I need to start my race, every race, as totally new. And, you know, I should never actually care about everything else that is going on in my life and just focus on the race, enjoy and learn every time I'm on the racetrack. So obviously there are a lot of planning and, you know, strategies that goes on behind, you know, before we start our races. But once the green flag is on, we forget everything else, and it's all about being in the right moment at that point of time and, you know, driving faster cars, how I need to overtake everybody else, how I need to perform my best. So all these feelings are always together, and by the time in this last 10 years, I have learned how to control all of those things together and, you know, take the best out of myself every time I'm on the racetrack. So yeah.
Right. So this Formula Racing, how did this come up in your mind? So I saw in your TEDx talks that your dad has a go-karting track as well.
Yes.
So how did the whole formula racing that thought came?
So basically, there's a process. So the highest level of motorsports in the whole world is Formula One, and before that comes a lot more steps. So first is karting, which is where I started. It's a four-stroke level karting. After that, it's professional level two-stroke karting. I drove in that category for 6 years, and after that, the next level is obviously the Formula Cars. There is a lower version of Formula Cars in India, that is the Formula 4 LGB cars, and that's where I started my journey in Formula racing. And after that, it was the Formula 4 cars that I have been driving since last 4 years now. This is going to be my fourth year. And in future, there are three more steps, obviously, that is Formula 3, Formula 2, and Formula 1. But as we go out of the country, especially out of India, the whole cost and everything else goes higher. So I mean, it depends on how much we have, how much skill we have, and as well as how much financial support we have. So it's a whole process. And my dream was obviously reaching Formula One in future. But as we all know, it's a super expensive sport. So Formula One is like really difficult, but taking one step at a time is something that I believe in, and that's why after racing in Formula Fours in India, now I'm planning. Last year I planned and did three international races in Formula Four, and now I'm really hoping that I can internationally go ahead and race in Formula Cars.